So this is the syllabus for your FA 1 exam. Unit 1, chapter 1 to 5, unit 2, chapter 9 to 13. So today we can start from chapter 1, the marine life.
Ma'am, I have completed all of them. Ma'am, means I have completed unit 1, full.
You have completed unit 1. Very good, Monashi. So yes, open page number 1.
Ma'am, I also have done.
Okay, very good. So Shreya Patro, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
The first name I can see in this list, Shreya Patro, you read this line. Marine life includes, so first of all, we will learn about what is marine life. Then we will learn about some animals we can see in the marine life. So what is that marine life? Shreya, you read this part.
Marine life includes an incredible and vibrant array of wild animals that live in the ocean, from teeny
phytoplankton to
enormous to whales. Marine life is the key source of food, energy, and life.
Okay, that's it. So marine life means mainly the aquatic life. So aquatic life means the lives or the animals and plants we can find both in oceans and even rivers, right? But marine life means, does it mean that the animals and plants live in rivers or not?
They live in water.
So the water animals and plants we can see. Marine life includes an incredible and vibrant array of wild animals that live in the ocean, water only. This is why I asked you. So aquatic animal means the animals that live in water. The water can be river water. The water can be backwater. The water can be like ocean water or sea water, anything. That is the aquatic life. And marine life means the lives in the oceans only. So we can say that all the marine animals are aquatic animals, but not all the aquatic animals are marine animals. Could you understand that line?
Yes.
All the marine animals are aquatic animals because marine animals live in oceans. And oceans are also part of aquatic life, or ocean animals are also a part of aquatic animals, but not all aquatic animals are marine animals, as not all aquatic animals live in oceans. So many aquatic animals are there that live in rivers, that ponds and lakes, right? So marine animals or marine life means the lives that we can see, the plants and animals we can see in oceans, from tiny phytoplankton to enormous blue whales. So what is the largest aquatic animal? We all know that.
Blue whale.
So from tiny phytoplankton. Phytoplankton means? A kind of plant, you can say. Okay, so from the tiny plants to large blue whales, everything we can see in this marine life. Marine life is the key source of food, energy, and life. Okay, now read the given clues and identify the wild marine animals. Take help from the utility box, write their names. So in the utility boxes, we can see some names. The Dumbo octopus, king crab, queen conch, the flamingo tongue snail, and the longhorn cowfish. The pictures are given here. So you tell me first, what is the name of this animal? The first one.
King crab.
This is the king crab. Yes, king and what crab. Is the name of this animal?
Queen conch.
No, this is not Queen Kong.
Dumbo octopus.
Yes, this is the octopus. Yes, Dumbo octopus. This is the Dumbo octopus. And this third one, what is the name of this one?
Flamingo tongue snail.
The flamingo tongue snail.
And this one?
Queen Kong.
Kong. Yes.
Queen Kong.
And the last one?
Longhorn
cowfish. Longhorn
cowfish.
Longhorn cowfish.
Which question or we'll get which answer. First question is, it can reach 11 inches in width and 10.5 to 12 pounds of weight. Some species have leg span of 8 feet. Males are generally larger than the females. Most species can be found in the warm waters of the southern hemisphere. King so what crab. Is that animal?
King crab. King
crab.
So let's see, what is that animal? So the animal is, yes, from the picture we can identify it is king crab.
King crab. King crab.
Yes. So now let's see what is the next one. Number two, it has soft head shaped body of 8 arms. So in which animal you can see 8 arms here?
Dumbo octopus.
Dumbo octopus.
From the name we can get. Octa means 8, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
No, all these abbreviations like mono, di, tri, tetra, then penta. You know all these things? In yes, science yes. You have learned? Mono means one. Di means
one.
Tri two. Means three. Tetra three. Means four. Tetra four. Means four. Penta means five.
Five.
Hexa means hexa. Means six.
Hexa means six.
Hexagons, you have drawn hexagons in chemistry. Hexa means yes, six. Hepta means hepta.
Seven.
And octa means?
Eight.
Okay. Up to 8 we will read now. So many numbers are also there. But I'm not telling those. Right now.
Ma'am,
we
Nona,
need
nine.
Nona. Ma'am, Nona means 9.
So right now we will read up to octa because we are talking about octopus. Octopus means they have 8 legs. This is why they are called octopus. And they are connected with each other via thin flaps of skin. 2 ear-like fins are positioned on both sides of their head. This interesting animal can be found in all the oceans of the world. Now let's see what is the answer. Not this one, wait. So the answer is, of course, Dumbo octopus. This one. This is how they look. Now let's see the third question. The answer, we have already just marked that what is the picture or the picture is of which animal. It is a marine gastropod mollusk. Gastropod mollusk. It belongs to the Ovulidae family, and the Ovulidae family is commonly known as cowrieales or false cowries. Okay, now what do you mean by mollusk? What do you mean by mollusk? Can anyone tell me? Mollusk means all the animals that have hard outer shell around their body. They are called mollusks, like snails and all the other animals that have hard outer shells around their body. They are called mollusks. And these are also gastropods. Gastropods means, you can see, pod means leg. Okay, you can see in this picture how yes. Their legs are. They are muscular. Most of the mollusks have muscular moving body or locomotive organ. So the body which, the part of their body which helps in their movement, that is called locomotive organ. So they don't have separate legs like octopus and crabs. In them, you have seen separate legs. They don't have that separate legs, but they have muscular locomotive part or organ. From which family they belong? They belong to the family of Ovulidae family. And the answer is
flamingo tongue
snail.
Flamingo tongue snail.
Now the next question, it is a large edible sea snail. Now what do you mean by edible? Who can tell me the answer?
Yes, we can eat it.
Yes, very good, Akhil and Mona Lisa. Edible means eatable. That means we can eat them. These are large edible sea snails. It's a type of marine mollusk. And this is also a mollusk, as you can see in this picture. They have hard outer shell. And can anyone tell me of which element these shells are made up of?
Keratin.
Calcium. Okay, calcium. Anything? Okay, you tell me. Our teeth and bone, these are also made up of calcium, right? Calcium makes these things strong or hard. So these, most of these outer coverings are made up of calciums that the mollusks have. It is native to the coasts of Caribbean, the Florida Keys, the Bahamas, and the Bermuda. They are herbivores. Herbivores means, tell me, who will tell? Herbivore means?
Animals eat green plants.
Yes, they will only eat green plants. And they eat algae. As they are marine animals, they live in water, so they will eat algae and other tiny marine plants. So this is why they are herbivores. And the answer will be queen conch. So this is how a queen conch looks. Next, they are found in shallow reefs and lagoons in the Red Sea. They are very popular. So where they are found? They are found in the shallow reefs and lagoons in the Red Sea. Red Sea and nearby areas. They are very popular in the pet trade, but aren't very well suited to living in aquariums due to the toxins. So generally people like to keep them as pets in their aquarium, but they do not live long in the aquariums because they cannot bear the toxins that are created there. So what is the name of this animal?
Longhorn cowfish.
Yes, and why is this longhorn cowfish? Can you tell me? See her face, how it looks. It looks like cow. And you can see these two horn-like structures.
Yes,
ma'am.
These actually help them to sense whether something is coming towards them, to sense the speed of the water, to sense the temperature. These are the sensory organs. So the answer will be longhorn cowfish. So I'm again quickly reviewing all the answers. The first answer will be king crab. The second answer will be Dumbo octopus. The third answer will be the flamingo tongue snail. The fourth answer will be
queen conch.
And the fifth answer will be
longhorn cowfish.
Okay. So what is written here? Did you know portion? An electric eel is known to produce electricity sufficient enough to light up 10 electricity bulbs. And it is also capable of killing a human being. Electric eels are animals that can produce electricity within their body. They can generate the electricity, and if we touch them, we can even die. Okay? And how much electricity it can generate? It can generate the electricity that can light up to 10 electric bulbs at once. Okay? And electric eels, these are also some marine animals. Now go to the second chapter. We have enough time today. We can also do this one. So this chapter is about the marsupials, right? So what are they? These are the members of the mammalian family that carry their young, that means the babies, in a pouch. So have you seen the picture of any of these mammals? Can you tell me any one example?
Kangaroo.
This is very common one because we have seen that they carry their babies in the pouch present in their body. Is koala. We have also seen koala. So these are also members of the family marsupials. A distinctive characteristic features. The animals who carry their babies in pouches present in their body. Exactly in front of their belly, they have pouches in which they carry their babies. Okay, and they are mammals also. They are mammals.
Ma'am.
Yes, Monoshi?
Ma'am, I tell in Bengali.
Why? You try to speak in English? I will try to understand what you are telling.
Ma'am, it is important. I want to tell in Bengali.
Okay, I will come to you. I will talk to you later. I will come to you.
Ma'am, the marsupials, they live in first in trees, but after sometimes the tree leaves gone to means coming less. They come from tree leaves in tree leaf mode. So they come down and eat the grass, and then the kangaroo and other marsupials.
Very good, very good, Monashi. Yeah. So here you are. You can speak in English. Totally. So why you told me that I want to tell in Bengali? Very nicely you have described that their history. Actually, yes. Previously, they used to live on trees that we can still see koalas live on trees now. But after some times when people started cutting down trees and there are lack of trees in that area, then they started adapting themselves so that they can live both on trees and on land also. And this is how in the next part of the time, we can see koala and as well as we can also see animals like kangaroos that live on the land. Yes, nicely said. But yes, this is how you should try to, you should be confident enough. You should try to speak in English. No problem. It doesn't matter if there is some mistake or not, but you at least try. And very good. Yes, very nice information you have shared with all your friends. Very good. Well-known marsupials include kangaroos and wallabies, koalas, and possums, opossums, wombats, and Tasmanian devils, and the recently extinct thylakines. So thylakines have recently been extincted. Can anyone tell me what does this word mean? Extinct?
They are not
anymore. They are species that are not found in the earth anymore.
Okay, one by one you tell me. Mona Lisa, first you tell me what you are telling.
Their species are not anymore found in earth.
Okay, and now Akhil, you were also telling something. Yes, the species, both of you are correct. The species that cannot be found now on earth, once we could find it, once they were, their existence was there, but now we can't find them on earth. So this is why it is called that thylakines are now. Yes, Shomodit, yes, now we cannot find them. So this is why they have gone extinct. Okay.
They have gone extinct because men catch them and sell in the animal bazaar.
Yes, because of the hunters, because of lack of food, because of lack of forest also, because the trees have been cut down now due to the deforestation also. They have lost their homes. They have lost their foods. So they have gone extinct. So these are the examples of some marsupials. Now let's see what is the first question.
Now I want to tell another thing, that one type of kangaroo live in trees now also.
Okay, and can you tell the name of them?
Tree kangaroo. They can't jump. Okay. They can't jump and live in tree.
Okay, and can you tell me that why can the movement of, yes, that is that one you have learnt in your previous class. What is the this type of jumping of kangaroos called, and why they are able to jump like that? This movement of kangaroo that they move by jumping, what is that movement called? That is called hopping, right? Hopping.
Yes, ma'am.
Hop. That is called hopping. And why they are able to hop?
Ma'am, because of their strong back legs.
And what those legs are called? Those strong, long back legs of kangaroo? Tenders. No, they are called hind limbs, right? Hind limbs. H-I-N-D. Hind. Hind limbs. You have learnt it in standard 6 maybe. Hind limbs. The frogs also have hind limbs. The rabbits also have hind limbs. This is why they are able to hop. Their movement is called hopping. Okay, now let's look here. So what will be the spelling? Tell me.
K-A-N-G-A-R-O-O.
So kangaroo. Kangaroos are large marsupials that are found only in Australia. They are identified by their muscular tails, strong back legs, large feet, short fur, long and pointed ears. So this is how a kangaroo looks. The picture is also given here. So this is the answer. Everyone write kangaroo there. Now what will this spelling be? Tell me.
A-W-A-N-A-W-A-B-A-B-Wallaby.
So what will be the pronunciation?
A-Wallaby.
A wallaby is a marsupial or pouched animal that is a member of the kangaroo family. There are around 30 different species of them. So this one also looks like a kangaroo, but see, a little bit different. They look a little bit different. I can't zoom this picture.
They are small in size.
Yes, in size they are smaller, and they also can bend themselves much more than the original kangaroos, right? The original kangaroos cannot bend themselves that much that a wallabies can do. These are also a member of kangaroo family. They also have pouches in front of their body where they keep their young ones.
Now, wallabies are dying.
Yes?
Wallabies are dying. Because of road
dying.
Accident.
And why they are dying, Monoshi?
Now, because of road accident.
Because of road accident, every year, a lot of wallabies die, yes, because they live in the forest areas, and now people are cutting down forests and making roads and buildings. This is the same problem with elephants in India also. Do you know that a lot of elephants are dying due to the road accidents, and even they come between the tracks of the trains, and due to the accidents they are dying in a huge number. Okay, now let's see question number 3. What is that? What is a
koala?
So tell me quickly. Tell me the spelling.
K W A L L L A S.
Koala. Koalas are often called bears because they look a little like teddy bears. Like other marsupials, the female has a pouch where she carries her baby, called a joey. For several months after the birth. Okay, the female koalas also have pouches just in front of their body. They have the pouches where they carry their children. Okay. Now, what is the name of this animal?
Wombat.
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 W-O-M-B-A-T-S.
M-B-A-T-S.
Wombats. So, wombats are second largest marsupials in Australia. They can reach up to 45 inches in length and are up to 80 pounds in weight. Okay? So, pound 80 pound means, okay, you tell me 1 pound means how many kilograms? Means? 0.5 kilogram, right? That means 500 gram?
500 grams.
So, 1 pound means 500 grams. So, you calculate, that means 80 pound will be how much gram or kilogram? You calculate that.
40 kilograms.
Near about. So they have that weight. Females are slightly bigger than the males. In that case, in case of wombats, we can see that the females are bigger than the males. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
You have joined with two devices.
Ma'am, there is more one.
More one, no, two are there. Okay, you that do it is, yourself in this page. I will give in the assignment section, okay? You write the answers and send me. The two answers that are left, I'm not writing it. You write it yourself.
Ma'am, that is as you, my near devil.
Yes, now I am going to give you the attendance. So everyone respond to me. This whole page I will send in the assignment section. You complete this page and send me the homework there. Okay.
Ma'am,